Hi, I'm Sarah. I'm originally from the United States. I have a background in opera. I did a bachelor's in the US and a master's in France, around opera performance. So I really was learning how to be an opera singer. I was an opera singer, and then at a certain point decided that as a single mom with two kids, that it just wasn't a viable option anymore. So at that point, I went and I started working in human resources for Nike and realized at a certain point that there was sort of a glass ceiling that had been put in place, and that if I really wanted to grow and really wanted to kind of step up, that I needed to look into a different career opportunity. I came to coding because I started a private project with some friends. We had a really amazing team of people put together and made it to the last round of a multi-million dollar investment opportunity. And at that point, our coder pulled out. And she just disappeared from one day to the next without leaving us any kind of beta. So at the point where we needed to provide an actual app, I decided that I would go ahead and start learning how to code. I found Codaisseur through just a Google search and looked at a couple other coding academies that were available. And really, at the end of the day, it was the demo night that kind of sealed the deal for me. I really liked what they were able to create, especially within such a short amount of time. The business model for me was also a major driving factor. So I left my job with two kids. And I started Codaisseur. I started Codaisseur in 2017. During that time, they were still teaching Ruby on Rails and then React. So the evolution was really, I think the first month or so was Ruby on Rails, and then we slowly moved into React. It was extremely intense at that point in time. I would drop the kids off at daycare in the morning, go to Codaisseur, learn to code for 8 hours, come home, pick the kids up, feed them dinner, put them in bed, and then go straight back to my computer to continue learning. A lot of people ask, how do you do it? And I think at that point, there just wasn't any other option. I had to be successful in this, and I had to be able to do it well, because really everyone's livelihood was riding on this kind of gamble that I had taken at the time. So during the academy, there were quite a few challenges, I think. First, I hadn't coded a line of code in my entire life, and that was a challenge. I guess I would say code. Even if you don't know what you're doing, code. The more familiar you are with your machine, or the more you understand how basic code works, the better off you're going to be, and the easier the academy, easier. It's never going to be easy. The more successful you have the potential to be. That was certainly a challenge. The other thing that sticks out in my mind as one of the biggest challenges was trying to code with two really little kids running around. There were certain assignments that were due or projects. And I think to this day, my kids still talk about the day where I had a project, it was ready to ship, and I broke something. To this day, I don't know what I did, but I broke it. And they were hungry, and I was stressed out, and I just started crying in the middle of the living room, crying. So my kids still bring that up 2 years later about, hey, mama, do you remember the time you started crying? So it's hard. It also reminds you how human you are. And then when graduation day does roll around, it makes it all that much more sweet that you realize that you had this huge journey to get there, and you started with next to nothing. And now, yeah, here you are ready to go out into the world as a junior developer, which is super exciting. I successfully finished Codaisseur, which I'm really, really thrilled about. And finding a job coming out of Codaisseur was actually surprisingly easy. And what was hardest for me was having the confidence to go ahead and move into a developer position.
Now I'm working as a full stack developer. We run three different apps that are, one is built in Ember and Rails, which is my baby. The other two are both full stack Clojure.
But it's really because I did Codaisseur and learned well how a tech stack functions and what is needed to build a full stack application that I was able to step into this position now of a little bit more cybersecurity oriented.
Yeah, Codaisseur for me was completely life-changing. If I look 2 years ago to where I am today, there's just no question that it was hands down one of the best opportunities and decisions that I've made. I know a lot of people think that I was completely crazy for leaving a well-paying job with two kids and just kind of throwing caution to the wind and saying, yeah, I'm going to go retrain in a different career that has absolutely nothing to do with what I initially set out to do. But yeah, looking at it now, I have a great job with wonderful people who are willing to invest in my continued education in a sector that I really actually have found a lot of passion for. I couldn't be happier.
I'm Sarah. I graduated from Codaisseur batch number 7 in 2017.